Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And the other day somebody had requested me for making a video on a topic which is related to remedies and child problems especially. So here is one example. This is the horoscope of a lady, and I had suggested her certain remedies to do. She was telling me that her son was facing so many problems, and her relationship with the son, with her son, was also not very great, and he always used to misunderstand her, and whatever she would do, the son would never understand. He would never cooperate. In fact, he would go outside and speak badly about his mother. In spite of her good efforts, the relationship was not very good. So I had suggested her some remedies to do, after which she had recently told me that there has been a lot of improvement in the relationship, and now she is enjoying a very good relationship with her son, luckily. And I told her that keep doing the remedies and mantras which I gave, and after that the problems will slowly start to disappear in totality. Although there are still some issues now, as from what she said to me, I can recall, she had said that there are some issues sometimes, but things are much better than earlier. Well, so let's see what is there. Okay, so there you go. If you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please go to my website and you can book a reading related to your career or wealth or love, romance, relationships, affairs, or health, or spirituality, or any specific placement in your horoscope, or if you want to know about your children or anybody in your family, then also. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. So now see what is happening in this chart. This is the chart of a lady, okay? So her moon is under affliction from Saturn and Ketu. Do you see this? Ketu is aspecting and Saturn is also aspecting. No other malefic aspects this. Mars doesn't aspect. Rahu doesn't aspect. Sun doesn't aspect. Okay? And neither is moon conjunct. So now moon is exalted in the ascendant here. It is in Rohini Nakshatra, fourth pada, because of which she looks quite good, I would say, above average, quite decent in her appearance. And apart from this, because there is this affliction, so see, generally when what I have observed is in charts of ladies, because moon represents the mother, so moon also not only represents their mother, moon also at times represents their ability to be like a mother. Okay, so now moon is exalted here. What does it mean? That means that she will be a very good mother. But there are these afflictions. Afflictions mean there is hindrance from outside. Okay, some other external factor is coming because of which your inherent ability to become a good mother is being challenged here. So what to do regarding that? So she has this affliction of moon, and whenever a planet is afflicted, we should protect the karaka of that house. So for example, moon is the karaka for which house? The fourth house, right? So generally, if the fourth house has malefics or if moon is afflicted, then we suggest the mantra Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya to chant, because this is a mantra related to Lord Krishna. But that is not enough. We have to go to the fifth house, because the problem is primarily coming from the fifth house. So now you see here, the fifth lord is Mercury. It is exalted and it is with Sun. So Sun and Mercury will signify Lord Ram. So I told her that you chant this mantra, Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. So this mantra I told her to chant 4 times in the morning, and Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya 1 time, 1 mala, okay, in the morning. So 4 malas of this mantra and 1 mala of this. And because Ketu is involved here, so whenever Ketu is connected to the 5th house, the person should worship Ganesh apart from the other planets. So I also told her that try to fast on Chaturthis, because Chaturthi was the day when Lord Ganesha was born. And if possible, give some donations to the temples of Lord Ganesh, if that is possible for you. Now, why did I suggest for Ganesh? Why not Ram? Because Surya is well placed here, you see. The problem is with Ketu. Ketu doesn't like very much to sit in earth signs. It likes to sit in fire signs and water signs, because that is where it can focus on its spiritual journey. But when it goes to air signs or earth signs, then what happens is it is forced to behave materially. So it's like an incompatible situation, you see. So the remedy has to be given for Ketu. But why did I suggest the remedy for Lord Ram also? Because when you chant the mantra of Lord Ram, the Sun-Mercury conjunction will improve. Mercury is Vishnu, Sun-Mercury represents the avatar of Vishnu, which is connected to the solar dynasty. Sun is the solar dynasty, which is Lord Ram, we all know. Raghuvanshi, Maryada Purushottam, Lord Ram. So, these two mantras I had suggested, and to fast on Chaturthi Tithis. Whenever in a month there is Chaturthi, I told her to fast, and then now she has responded that things are pretty good. And also Jupiter is the natural significator of husband and children also in a woman's chart. So Jupiter is sitting in the 10th house, which is very good, although it is in an enemy sign. Actually, Aquarius is not kind of an enemy sign, but still you can call it, because Saturn is in the other party of friends. Like Saturn is the friend of Venus and Mercury, which are enemies of Jupiter, of course. So because of that, I still would consider Aquarius as an enemy sign, although officially it is not. Because sometimes when Jupiter sits in Aquarius, it becomes too much focused on worldly things rather than focusing on spirituality. That's the problem. But at the same time, house-wise, it is very well placed, 10th house. So because of this, the lady will earn a lot of name and fame through her son. Okay, because now she is having a son. So Jupiter is the karaka for children. So for her case, it is a son. So, and it is unafflicted, you see. Rahu is not afflicting, Mars is not afflicting, Saturn is not afflicting, no other afflictions. And the fifth lord is exalted here, Mercury is exalted in own sign. So this is how we suggest remedies, and there are different ways and things to consider which I have not taken into consideration here, because then it becomes a very long video and other details are not to be revealed, like her birth details or which year she was born, etc., and which dasha is going on. Those are not important. Important is that we try to suggest remedies, and then remedies work ultimately. Okay, so there you go. And yes, before I end, I would again say that you may have these placements, but that doesn't mean that you will have problems with your son or with your daughter, or you may not have these planets and you might still have problems. Okay, that depends on so many other factors which I will not explain here, because that's not the topic of this video. The video's topic is to highlight remedies. Okay, so there you go. If you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video below. Okay, until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye, see you.